this is a 23, and we're going to take a slightly different approach to these type of questions. We've got an inverse tangent of this, and again, remember, this is a this is not an angle. It is a trig value. So remember, this is some angle trig. The tangent of some angle gives us this value. So then, when we take the inverse, we're getting back to the angle. However, since we're going to take the sine of that angle, we don't necessarily need to know what the angle is. What we need to do is construct the triangle that would have created the value. So remembering that, if I can, let's see, that tangent of some angle is equal to the opposite over adjacent, and that sine is equal to the opposite over hypotenuse for the same from the same triangle, the same angle. Okay, we've got the same angle. So what we're given is that the inverse tan is 5/12. So that's telling us what the opposite over adjacent is, that the opposite side, let's draw this triangle, try to go this route, it's some theta. So the opposite angle, the opposite is 5, the adjacent is 12. And then we need to now find the hypotenuse. Now this is where we add the two legs together, the squares of the two legs, and take its square root. So 5 squared plus 12 squared. Now some of you had asked, when do we add, when do we multiply? Well, for finding the hypotenuse, we always will add. If we have the hypotenuse in one leg, that's when we subtract. We're subtracting one of the legs from the hypotenuse to get it. So there's those two types. But with tangent, we always have the opposite and adjacent. We have the two legs, so we're going to add them together. So this gives us 25 plus 144. Is that going to be 169? In fact, it is, which is the square root of 13. So a lot of times they're kind of being nice to us, and they give us these Pythagorean triples, 5, 12, and 13. And if you're into trig enough and using it regularly, you'll remember these numbers. I do a lot of other things, and so I don't remember them all. I do remember the 3, 4, 5. That's one standard, but probably everybody does. This one's a little bit more out there. Okay, so our hypotenuse is 13. So when we go to sine, we need the opposite over hypotenuse. So we're finding. We take our tangent to set up the triangle. If we needed to, we could actually find what this angle is, but then you're just going to take the sine of that angle, so we don't really need that. What's the sine of this angle? Well, opposite over hypotenuse, 5 over 13. Okay, so that's what they're looking for. And they want the exact value. They don't want the decimal value anyway, so this pi is kind of just throwing you off the trail. Could have been a square root, but it wasn't. It was one of these 5 over 13. So it's opposite over hypotenuse. That's 23. So when you see these ones, make your triangle, and then use that triangle to find the next value.